Hello, this is Eric Bolt from the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Here is a quick look at the El Nino status and predictions for the upcoming 2015 and 16 winter season for Southwest California. Here is the latest ENSO information. An El Nino advisory is in effect. The Pacific Ocean continues to reflect sustained and strengthening El Nino conditions. There's a 90% chance of an El Nino this winter. And it's possible that El Nino could be in the strong category, which is significant because past strong events have resulted in above normal rainfall, while weak or moderate El Ninos have not been as reliable for Southern California. Let's talk about what normal conditions look like across the equatorial Pacific Ocean. Trade winds push warmer water to the western Pacific closer to Australia, which in turn fuels the atmosphere, resulting in more storm activity. Cooler water and subsiding air across the eastern Pacific do not bring as much storminess to that region. During an El Niño, trade winds often weaken or reverse direction, which allows the warmer water to move eastward toward the eastern Pacific coast of South America. This fuels storm systems across the eastern Pacific, especially during the winter months, and results in drier conditions over the western Pacific. A recent global satellite image confirms that more cloud cover and storminess are already occurring across the eastern Pacific, as outlined by the red oval above. The attached graphic is a measurement of solar radiation in the last 4 weeks, with blue shading showing where there was cloud cover and orange shading a lack of cloud cover. Sea surface temperature anomalies in the last 4 weeks remain above average across most areas east of the dateline. This is where we want to see this occurring and is a positive sign for El Nino. This chart shows sea surface temperatures across different areas of the Pacific going back to last year at this time on the left side of the diagram versus current time on the right. After March, all areas saw increasing water temperatures and the latest numbers remain high. The Niño 3.4 region is an area monitored closely for El Niño and was last reporting 1.7 degrees Celsius above normal. El Niño conditions start at 0.5 degrees with a strong category beginning at 1.5 degrees. There have been comparisons made with the current sea surface temperature anomalies to those from early winter of 1997, which was the last strong El Niño and was well remembered for the impacts it had across Southern California. The red shading shows the above normal temperatures across the eastern Pacific Ocean near the equator for November 1997 on the left and July 2015 on the right. Note the differences in the eastern North Pacific region, where sea surface temperatures are much warmer than normal than in 1997. This could also be a sign of the Pacific Decadal Oscillation, or PDO, moving into a warm phase, which has not happened since 1997-98. Computer models are predicting that this winter's El Niño could range from a weak to a strong event. However, the average consensus of all the models are in the 1.5 to 2.5 degrees Celsius range, which would put us into a strong category El Niño by this fall. With El Niño predicted through the upcoming winter season, here is the precipitation outlook for the rainy season months of December through February. There is a greater than 40% chance of being wetter than normal across Southwest California. Normal annual rainfall ranges from about 15 to 25 inches across the area. The temperature outlook for the December through February time frame calls for having equal chances of below, normal, above, or normal temperatures for the season. A warmer temperature signal is shown across Northern California. Here are some conclusions. El Niño tilts the odds of above normal rainfall for Southwest California this winter. The strength of this El Niño is the most difficult prediction. Right now, it does favor a strong event. One El Niño winter season will not end the drought. We have over a 30-inch rainfall deficit in 4 years. Prior to the rainy season, we should be prepared for a dangerous wildfire season. Thank you for watching this presentation. If you have any comments or concerns, please contact me at the number shown here. And please visit our website at weather.gov/Los Angeles or at our social media listed below. Thank you.